I want to take you on a short tour of the screens of the Bernina 570 Quilters Edition on the sewing machine side. So when you turn your machine on, you'll come right to the straight stitch and kind of the utility grouping of stitches. So let's talk about stitches and how we select stitches, and then we'll come over here and identify what each of these functions are. So as you pick a stitch, you're going to notice that this little stitch window will show you what stitch is selected, even if you have moved on to another screen. So even though I haven't picked another stitch, if I was to sew, I'll still get the zigzag showing right here. I will also be able to see any changes to this stitch that I might make with the stitch width or stitch length knob. So if I want to make this wider, you can see that the stitch grows, and you'll also be seeing that the stitch numbers, or if you have changed them from the default, have changed to the color of yellow. So yellow is a term that, as we see it, that means that you have touched it, changed it, and it's no longer on the default setting. No problem, because clear, the CLR option, can be touched to easily get back to the original setting of that stitch, but not necessarily changing the settings of all the stitches. And that's something that we'll talk about, being able to customize one stitch, customize a second stitch, and then be able to go between them without the settings changing. And I love that feature on the Berninas. So to get through to stitches, you can touch and drag up and find stitches this way. And there is a lot of stitches, and that's why we'll be talking throughout these videos about the importance of making a stitch book. Take the time to stitch out all your decorative stitches, and then that way you know what's in this machine. You can also touch this little arrow here, and that expands, a little touch there, expands the window so you can see even more stitches at any given time. Once you select one, you'll notice that it'll kind of bring back that half of the screen version for that stitch. You have decorative stitches here, and again, each of these folders has groupings of stitches that you can go into and stitch out. We have alphabets that we'll work with in the memory part of this machine. And to get to memory, that's what this plus is. Very common for people to ask, what's this? Well, when you touch it, you'll notice that your stitch disappears. And that means that the machine is waiting for you to select multiple items, and it will arrive in this place. So if I was spelling out a word like cat, you will see the C, A, and T will show up on screen. But if I'm not in memory, then all I'd be stitching out would be a row of letters. So we have decorative stitches, and don't forget, when you want to come back out, touch the block one step back to come back to where we started. Alphabets, buttonholes, yes, and there's lots of buttonholes to choose from. Quilting menu here, and we'll be talking about how you can store your favorite stitches in this area. So make sure you don't miss any of the videos that we have done. We've actually done them so you can watch them in order at sewingmastery.com, and then that way you don't miss a little segment along the way. So again, we're just talking about a quick overview of how to get around the machine right now. So I'm going to just go back to a straight stitch so we can see where we're at. There'll be things that we can do for adjusting stitches, like mirror image or lengthening it out, or even saving or overriding the default settings of the stitch. So those will be ways that you can personalize this machine. Touching the X will get you out of that. So that's a quick overview of this area. Search if you know the stitch number you want to type in. So let's see here, is it 413? And check mark is the heart. Yes, I have memorized a few of my favorite stitches, if that might be something for you to work with as well. Over here on the side, the little home button, this would take you or toggle you to the embroidery side. We have the settings of the machine, things you can set up of the machine for the way you sew. We'll go into each of these two with individual videos. Kind of your onboard manual is in here. Touch that little book for that. Our creative consultant talks about how we can tell the machine what fabric we're working on, and then tell the machine what technique we're doing. Like, so if I'm putting a zipper in a pair in a heavier fabric, it will automatically select the right stitch tell me which foot I need to be on, and adjust many of the settings just for me. So I love that feature of this machine. I'm going to push clear, and then we'll be back to where we need to be. If you ever wonder what something is along the way, touch the question mark, and with the blue question mark showing on screen, you can touch a stitch, a function, or ask the machine a question. So this is one of the triple straight stitches, one of my favorites for embellishment and also any of my heavy work. I love to use this stitch, and it reminds me of how to get things set up for that particular stitch. You're noticing that this stitch is red right now. It's because I picked a zipper and it thinks I'm using a zipper foot. So I'm gonna go in here, tell the machine that I'm actually using a standard presser foot 1C, and then it will let me actually sew that stitch. So that is one thing you may need to make sure your foot is appropriately selected for the stitch you're working with. So coming over to this side, that's what we found in here. So you can actually identify which foot you're working with. And again, it will make sure that you are set up in the correct way as you are stitching. The top one here is tension. You'll notice that this box actually changes the tension number based on the stitch you have selected. So for our straight stitch, we have a tension of approximately 5.25, which you can change up or down, plus or minus, or touch the yellow box for it to go back to normal. So that is something we'll talk about tension throughout these videos as well. Pressure adjustment. Again, you can adjust how firm this foot is coming down on your fabric, but again, it'll get you into a ballpark as you pick certain stitches. This is a part I use a lot because I do switch from my normal stitch plate to the straight stitch throat plate for different uses. Plus, when I do double needle work, I can always set the machine for the twin needle or double needle I'm working with, and then it will actually show me the stitch in doubled, for you to see what it's going to look like when you have a twin needle on. Notice it's yellow, so if I go back in here, I'm going to put it back to the normal setting, and I should be good to go. Feed dogs up or down, this would alert whether I should lower them or lift them back up, but the option for actually changing that is on the side of the machine. Touch the little box over on the side, just right below where your foot control is plugged in. And then right here, this is the indicator for when your bobbin gets low. I wanna say it's somewhere in the below of 16% or so. It starts to kind of blink and warn you you're on your tail end of your bobbin. So for screen-wise, that will get you around to kind of the basics and help you understand. We're going to go into each of those items even further as we continue with additional videos. So if this is exciting for you and you can't wait to dive in to all these great features, make sure you check out the links below in this YouTube description. And if you're looking to do your stitch book, I highly recommend that's a great place to start. And don't forget, if you're loving the idea of learning more about this machine, check out our Bernina Stitching Cosmos online course.